Shalom Aleichem, friends. My name is Siddur Hernandez. I'm a teacher here at Harange Messianic Synagogue, and I would like to welcome you to another edition of Insights from the Siddur, where we will be understanding the importance of the blessings of the Torah. Now, this comes from page 17 of the Art School Siddur or the Art School Siddur app. Now, in Judaism, it is critical that we pray a blessing before performing any mitzvah, any commandment, especially before studying the Torah, because that is the source of the mitzvot, the source of the commandments. If we turn to Yirmiyahu, Jeremiah chapter 9, verses 11 through 12, it tells us this: for what reason did the land perish? But Hashem has said, because of their forsaking my Torah. According to the Talmud, this verse tells us that the destruction of the land of Israel resulted from the fact that our ancestors did not pray a blessing before they studied the Torah. Why is that such a big deal? Well, they saw the Torah simply as a source of knowledge, as a science like any other. It was as if they were reading a school textbook on biology or astronomy, right? Friends, the Torah is not just any book. We must treat the Torah with the honor that it merits as we pray in the blessings of the Shema during our Ma'ariv evening prayers. This is what we say: for they, meaning the words of Torah, for they are our life and the length of our days. Friends, the Torah is everything to us. It merits a blessing. Now, the blessing begins with the normal formula: blessed are you, Lord our God, right? And then it goes on to say, who has sanctified us with his commandments and commanded us to engross ourselves in the words of Torah. It is because, friends, it is because we are sanctified, it is because we are set apart by his mitzvot that he commands us to do, that he commands us to do his mitzvot. Now, we don't do the reverse. We don't do in order to be sanctified in Judaism. We don't, quote unquote, work for our salvation, contrary to popular opinion. We don't study Torah. We don't eat kosher. We don't celebrate the festivals to earn being set apart. That would make us posers. That would make us pretenders, my friends. And that's not who we are. We keep his mitzvot because we are set apart. Just look at the book of Yohanan, John chapter 14, verse 15. Yeshua tells his disciples, if you love me, you will keep my mitzvot. You will keep my commandments. Notice the order. It is because we love him that we keep his mitzvot. It is because we are set apart and sanctified that we keep his mitzvot. Now, the words to engross ourselves in Torah mean to busy ourselves in his words and in the Torah. Now, life is full of busy activities, isn't it? Everywhere you turn, there's some kind of distraction in our modern lifestyles, right? But if we really think about it, these busy activities have no eternal significance. They're going to remain here. They're not going to go with us into eternity. As Jewish believers in Yeshua, my friends, we are to busy ourselves with things of eternal significance, especially the study of Torah. The blessing goes on to say, sweeten the words of your Torah in our mouth. Studying the Torah, friends, takes effort. It takes time. It takes devotion. A good friend of mine says this all the time. He says, how do you spell love? T-I-M-E, right? Whatever we spend time doing, whoever we spend time with, that shows what we love and who we love, right? Initially, friends, it can be difficult to spend time with him, to spend time in his Torah. It can be difficult to overcome the many busy distractions that life puts in our way. Nevertheless, as a reward for the effort, the time and the devotion that we put into studying his Torah, we ask Hashem to do this one thing. Please, Lord, make it sweet. Make it sweet for us. Friends, our human nature, what it wants is it wants sweetness before engrossing, right? It wants to feel led to studying Torah. Oh, I don't feel led today, right? I don't feel the Spirit leading me to do this or that, right? That's not Judaism, my friends. That's not Torah. That's not Bible, right? We want to feel led to study Torah before we actually put in the work, when it should be the opposite. Look at Shemot, the book of Exodus, chapter 24, verse 7. Listen to what it says. And he, meaning Moses, he took the book of the covenant, which is the Torah, and read it within the hearing of the people. This is at Mount Sinai during Shavuot. And they said, all that Hashem spoke, we will do and we will hear. Friends, when our ancestors received the Torah on Mount Sinai during Shavuot, they did not say, you know what? As soon as we hear what you want us to do, and as soon as we analyze it and dissect it and discuss the pros and cons, then we will agree to do what you say. That's not what they said. They fully trusted in Hashem's Torah, that it is for our good. They will do the mitzvot, and then they will seek understanding, and then they will seek analysis. That is true faith. That is true faith and true trust. What's wonderful about Hashem is that He sees our effort in anything we do and anything we busy ourselves with for Him. And then you know what He does? He makes it sweet. But we've got to go in that order, my friends. We've got to go in that order. The blessing goes on. May we and our offspring and the offspring of your people, the house of Israel. Okay, our duty, friends, is to pass on what we have learned in our Torah study to our children, relatives, fellow believers, and all those around us, even non-believers. We're to pass this on and not hoard it for ourselves. That just leads to pride. Look at Matidyahu chapter 28, verses 19 through 20. The book of Matthew, Yeshua says to his disciples, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, immersing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. Teach them all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always to the end of the age. Friends, how do we make disciples of all nations? Well, we teach them. What do we teach them? We teach them what we have studied. We teach them Torah, the exact Torah that Yeshua commanded us, which, by the way, is the exact same Torah that was given at Mount Sinai to our forefathers. As we do this, friends, He promises that He is always with us. How sweet is that? It goes on to say, all of us, may all of us know your name and study your Torah for its own sake. Friends, we don't study Torah to show off how much we know. This is pride. This blessing helps keep our motives right. We must study Torah for the sake of knowing Torah, for the sake of drawing closer to Him. Friends, in order to avoid delaying the observance of the mitzvah for which the Torah study blessings were said, we immediately recite a passage from the Torah, which is the Birkat Kohanim, the blessing of the priests. The blessing says, the Birkat Kohanim says, may Hashem bless you and keep you. According to the Midrash Rabbah, it states, may God bless you. What this is saying is, may God bless you with riches, with children, and may protect you. May He protect you from thieves. So in other words, the blessing says, may God bless you with material blessings that you can enjoy in this life, and may they not be taken away from you, right, by thieves. The blessing goes on. May Hashem make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Midrash Rabbah states, this means that Hashem, shall enlighten your eyes and your heart through your understanding of Torah. How beautiful is that? And He shall grant you children who are sons of Torah. Again, we pray the blessing of the Torah to understand the Torah, that our eyes will be open, our heart will draw near to Him. And then whatever we learn, we pass on to our children, that they may become sons and daughters of Torah. Here, friends, we are also praying that through Torah study, our mind will meet with the mind of Hashem and become enlightened with His wisdom. May we have the mind of Mashiach. Sound familiar? And the last part of the blessing, may Hashem turn His countenance to you and give you shalom, give you peace. This is, friends, this is the peace that surpasses all understanding that comes from a personal relationship with Hashem in Yeshua, our Mashiach. How beautiful is that? Let's study the Torah, friends. Let's study the Torah. And before we study that Torah, let us pray the blessing, giving the Torah the merit that it deserves. It is our life and the length of our days. May God bless you, and may God surround you with His shalom today. Shalom aleichem, my friends. All the best. Until next time.